Hi there, it's Eric Backer, New Zealand naturopath, author of Candida Crusher. Thank you for checking out the video. I've got a question here from a YouTube subscriber called Wilmore Benedictos, and Wilmore's asking me, does microwave food with yeast, does microwaving food that contains yeast kill the fungi? If yes, should I eat it? Right, Wilmore, well, this would be a good question really to sort of answer to and explain. And I'm not a huge fan at all of microwave food. In fact, I wrote about microwave cooking in Candida Crusher. You can read about that, why I don't think it's the best kind of food for you to eat. I find it quite interesting that people tend to spend a lot of time selecting the best kind of foods. They tend to avoid refined foods or processed foods. We realize that. Foods that contain pesticides or sprays. But then a lot of people don't mind eating food, you know, that's contained in styrofoam containers or those little cups, styrofoam cups, where they'll wrap food in aluminum foil. They'll put food in really hot ovens. They'll boil the hell out of food, and they'll even put it in microwave ovens. An experiment I did a long time ago when I was a student was to place some water in a microwave oven and heat it up and then use that water, microwaved water, for a plant that I grew in my house. And I had another similar plant that we gave just plain rainwater to, and the difference was astounding. You could see week by week the foliage would shrivel up, the plant wasn't growing, and after about 3 months the plant that got the microwave water had died. So when you see those sorts of things happening, you start to realize, well, what benefit have I got from, you know, eating food or drinking water or tea or anything that's been heated up in a microwave? What benefit is it going to do to my body? So if it's going to kill a plant, it might end up killing some of your cells. We know that microwaves or the radiation is dangerous. We know about that with mobile phones, and we know about that with landline phones that we use with, you know, that emit quite high radiation. And we also know that microwaves leak. Particularly after many years, you can actually get a detector and run it around a microwave that's on and find that it will leak radiation. So it's not the best thing to have really in the kitchen, in the house, particularly with young children. I've had patients over the years that have seen me with tumors, brain tumors. One case in particular, a lady in her 20s who had a tumor here, right here in the front of her brain. And one of her jobs was working in a daycare center and putting baby bottle in a microwave and then warming it up on high for about short bursts of 60 seconds. Now, she did this about 20 or 30 times a day. And after her brain surgery, the neurosurgeon actually asked her if she used a microwave oven, because he'd seen those kind of tumors linked with microwave use. So, you know, it's your choice if you want to use a microwave heating up food. Another thing I want you to think about is that microwaves destroy enzymes in foods, right? So enzymes are in plant-based foods, and these enzymes actually help to degrade or rot the food. And that's why healthy, fresh food, you know, you can only keep for a short period of time. Enzymes serve many different purposes in vegetables and fruits, but these are degraded and destroyed. And many health experts believe that the lack of enzymes in processed foods we eat is one of the reasons why we only live, some of us live for half, you know, or even a third of our potential, particularly people who eat a lot of processed foods, you know, deep fried things and things like that. So, but there are other reasons why microwaves aren't that good for you either, and that's the high temperature will denature protein. So when you take protein up to a very high temperature, you denature it. You create a problem with the amino acid bonds in the protein, which makes it very hard for your body to break those protein structures down and absorb it. So not the best idea really to use microwave cooking. So, but does it kill fungi? Well, I'm pretty well sure it would kill fungi, but I think you'd kill the food as well. And then with microwaves also, are you penetrating to, you know, the innermost part of the food? That's the other thing you have to ask yourself. So why would you want to microwave food that has the potential to have fungi? Just throw it out. And should we eat it? Well, I don't think you should eat any food that's cooked in a microwave oven, because I just don't think it's fit for human consumption. But that's my personal opinion. I prefer to steam foods, eat them raw, or lightly cook them, or grill them, or very lightly pan fry them in olive oil. But with microwave, it's not really an item I choose to have in my kitchen. But again, it's your choice. So I hope that answers your question, Wilmore, regarding microwave ovens. Thank you very much.